You ready?
Dealing with the toxic people in our lives, we all have them, but we all have not learned how to deal with them effectively. What is toxic people? Come on, y'all. Abusing you physically, that make you compromise who you are, that brings pain to you emotionally, financially. Any person that makes you less than who you are, anyone that brings out the worst in you instead of the best in you, is considered a toxic person. Hey guys, and welcome back to another Law of Attraction video. Let me first start by saying, guys, you guys are so awesome. I know I said this in one of my other videos, but I just want to take a moment real quick and just say thank you so much, guys, for all the love and support and encouraging words that you guys are giving me on this Law of Attraction series. I'm so just elated at you guys' response level. You know, you guys have been very engaging, your comments and everything like that, and just your level of support has really just, man, you guys really just inspire and encourage me. So I just want to tell you guys, thank you so much. Thank you for all my new subscribers. Oh my goodness. Thank you. Okay. So without further ado, guys, let's get into it, right? So this topic, judging by some of you guys' comments, had to be the next topic I tackled, guys. This is a very, very, very important issue that we must talk about and learn how to deal with. And this is none other than dealing with the toxic people in our lives. We all have them. We all have them, and we've all had to deal with them, but we all have not learned how to deal with them effectively. You understand what I'm saying? And this is what this video is for, so that we can learn how to deal with the toxic people. I call them the fools in your life. You understand what I'm saying? Like, how do you deal with them effectively? You understand? So what is toxic people? Come on, y'all. Y'all know what toxic people is. Anyone that make you compromise who you are. Anyone that, you know, that brings pain to you. Anyone that's abusing you physically, emotionally. You understand what I'm saying? Financially, even. You know what I'm saying? Any person that makes you less than who you are. You understand what I'm saying? Anybody that makes you have to come out of character, anyone that brings out the worst in you instead of the best in you, is considered a toxic person. Did you hear what I just said there? If the people that are, if the friends, family, you know what I'm saying, whoever it is that you, whoever it is that's around your life, if they're bringing out the worst in you instead of cultivating the best in you, they're toxic. They are toxic, and you're gonna have to make a decision. You understand what I'm saying? You're gonna have to make an executive decision on what to do and how to handle them. So without further ado, let's get into how to deal with these toxic people. Now, these are not in any particular order. I got like five things that I want to share with you real quick, and by no means is this all the tips or all the ways to deal with them, okay? But my number one is in order, and my number one is the only one that's in order. But it's very vital, guys. Number one is avoid them. Avoid them. If you can avoid them, if you can cut them off, cut them off. You understand what I'm saying? I don't care if it's family. Okay? I don't, you know, I understand society say blood is thicker than water. No, honey, unless it's the blood of Jesus, don't bring that mess to me. You understand what I'm saying? That's why a lot of people, they're so brainwashed by culture and society and all of this. Like I used to tell my husband all the time, let me tell you something. I don't go by culture or what society says or culture says. I go by my biblical culture. I go by who flows through my bloodlines now. My bloodlines tell me that my Heavenly Father, my Creator, that is who my culture is. That's whose blood is thicker than water. Do you understand what I'm saying? Because let me tell you what I don't do. I don't co-sign on wrong behaviors. That's what I don't do. I'm not going to sit up in garbage and be around toxic people when it's constantly dragging me down. It's constantly putting me in a negative headspace. You know, it's constantly, you know, making me get out of character or making me feel bad about who I am. Do you understand what I'm saying? So this is when you gotta level up. You gotta put your big girl panties on and make an executive decision to cut them off. Because what's more important to you? Your integrity, your self-respect, your dignity, or being in the company of these people, just having these people around just so that you can say you're around them, just so that you can have, just so you can socialize, just because you're trying to avoid them talking about you, calling you a goody two-shoes, or calling you, you think you're better than or holier than thou. So what would they think about you? Let them think what they want. They don't have a heaven or hell to put you in, and toxic people use that to manipulate you because they are jealous of who you are. So of course, they're gonna say, well, you think you better than, well, you act like you holier than thou. Yes, you are better than. If you are the kind of person that likes to bring value to other people's lives and you like to operate in a level of integrity and self-respect and dignity, then yes, you are better than them. Because let me tell you something about toxic people. The Bible refers to them as fools. Let me tell you something. The Bible says, don't argue with a fool because you're going to lose every time. There's a reason why God said that. So our Bible also says that a fool abhors instruction. That's why you don't try to do a reason with them. You're going to lose. So stop. You know, stop casting your pearls among swine. The Bible says they will trample over them. They will trample them. Please don't do it. Don't get trampled. You understand what I'm saying? So if you can avoid them, please do it. It's going to make for you a better life. Your life is going to be more peaceful. And then when you get rid of the toxic people, you give room for God to bless you with the right kind of people. You understand what I'm saying? Just because y'all family, my Bible tells me when Jesus answered that question, when he said, who is my mother and my father? No, he said, who is my brother or my sister or my mother? Remember that scripture where he's like, well, who is my sister and who is my mother? Aren't those who do the will of my father? That's who my brothers and sisters are, right? So that's what you gotta ask yourself. Let me tell you something. People put too much emphasis on family and put too much emphasis on friends and put too much emphasis on culture and too much emphasis on society. Culture, society, family, and friends is gonna get you sent straight to hell. Culture, family, friends, and society is going to make you lose out on the blessings of your life. Do you understand what I'm saying? The only person who you should be loyal to and revere, you understand what I'm saying? Is God, is the great I am. You understand what I'm saying? Is the great I am. So remember that. You understand? The Bible has a whole lot to say about toxic people, about fools. And I might title this video, How to Deal with the Fools in Your Life, Honey. All right? And don't get mad at me. I didn't write the word, okay? Get mad at Jesus, honey, because I'm going to tell you something. And you guys, the other thing that you guys got to keep in mind is that, this is a side note. One of the things that you guys got to keep in mind, honey, is you're not dealing with the person. You're dealing with the spirit behind the person. So when the person is acting toxic and foolish and ignorant, that is a spirit, honey, that you are dealing with. You understand what I'm saying? And that is one of the short ways that you can that you will be able to see that God is trying to level you up. God is trying to bring you up. How do you know that God is trying to level you up? Is there will be fools, okay, that will be assigned to you that will start trying to hinder you. You understand what I'm saying? As some of the young people call it, they will start being petty towards you. Do you understand what I'm saying? That, my friend, don't get upset when you start seeing these demons, you know, when you start seeing their horns come out their head. That is an indication to you from God that you are on a whole nother level. And the enemy is trying to distract you from that level by getting you to come out yourself and out of character and come down to that level of foolishness and ignorant behavior. Don't do it. Don't do it, which has brought to bring me into my next, my number two point, how to deal with these toxic people. And this, if you guys do this, I'm telling you guys, it's going to take you to a whole nother spiritual level. It's going to put you in another bracket mature-wise. You understand what I'm saying? It's going to take your maturity to another level. You're going to be in a whole nother, you're going to be in a whole nother realm. And so this tip I actually heard on YouTube by a man by the name of Dr. Walter Jacobson, and he said, neutralize their negativity. Neutralize their negativity. I love that saying. A lot of you guys probably do this. I was doing this and didn't even realize it. I didn't have a name to put to it, but it's called neutralize their negativity. What does that mean? Well, number one, knowing who you are mentally. When you know who you are, you don't give no energy to it. Neutralizing their negativity. Don't give energy to it. When you know who you are, whatever they're saying to you or doing to you, don't let it affect you. Number one, understand who you are. And you know doggone well that you ain't did nothing to them. Don't make their issue your issue. That's another way you neutralize it. Don't make their issue your issue. Ignore that demon. Because when that demon starts being petty towards you and start doing things, they are looking for a response from you. They are provoking you to get out of character, to distract you away from destiny. Do you understand what I'm saying? Ignore it. Don't give their behaviors any energy. Know who you are. Well, let me tell you something. That's what leaders do. Don't let them lower your vibration. Do you understand what I'm saying? But when you neutralize their negativity, what you do is you bring them up to your vibration. That's what a leader do. Don't give it no energy. What you do when you neutralize their negativity, you disarm them. You disarm that spirit. Do you understand what I'm saying? Which brings me to my third point is to love them. This is the most important of them all. Love them. Let me tell you what love do. You understand what I'm saying? The Bible says, through love and kindness have I drawn thee. It's one of those things, you have to love them through their foolishness. You got to understand that their behavior towards you is not personal. This is something that they're dealing with inwardly. These are the demons that they're battling. And it's a direct reflection of what's going on inside of them. So you pray for them. It's a desperate and it's a sick way of crying out for help. When people are evil towards you, when they're petty towards you, when they're just downright mean, disrespectful, and just ugly, they're really crying out for help. It's a sick way of doing it. I understand it. But as a leader, love them through their sin. Love them through their ugliness. Like they say, hate the sin, but love the sinner. You understand what I'm saying? Separate their foolishness from the person, because again, you're dealing with a spirit, guys. You're dealing with a spirit that is on assignment to attack you, to rob, kill, and destroy you, rob you of your joy, kill you of your character, your self-respect, your dignity. So remind yourself of who you are. When you're able to love them, it's kind of hard for a toxic person to still be toxic towards you when you're operating in the spirit of love. That's how you disarm them. You understand what I'm saying? And I know that is a hard thing to do. That's why I said if you do this, it's gonna take you to a whole nother level spiritually. You're gonna boss up. You're gonna go to a whole nother level in your leadership capabilities. You understand what I'm saying? If you do this, you're winning. If you do this, you defeat the adversary in your life. Do you understand what I'm saying? And how do you show love? The Bible says a soft word turneth away wrath. Okay, it can be just do a kind word. You can decide to do a random act of kindness towards them. Do you understand what I'm saying? There's a lot of ways that you can show love towards the toxic people in your life, and you'll be amazed at how that spirit will flee. You will literally watch it flee. You understand what I'm saying? You will literally watch it disarm itself. You understand what I'm saying? So love is the most powerful tactic against toxic people. Guaranteed, guys. I'm telling you, trust me on this one. The next one, I love this, and I think I heard on YouTube, there was this guy, his name, his channel is Brendan.com, I think that's his channel name or whatever. And I heard him say this on his channel and I loved it. And I just had to put this in this video, guys. And one of the things he said is, which is my number four, is how to deal with toxic people. Get better. Not in spite them, but despite them. And I loved how he said that. He said, get better, not in spite them, but despite them. You understand what I'm saying? In other words, don't matter what they're doing, you just continue getting better. You continue excelling. You understand what I'm saying? That is like a weapon against toxic people. Don't come down to their level. Don't entertain their level. Know what level you're on and know what level you're trying to achieve. Do you understand what I'm saying? Let them stay down here, but don't you come from up here to down here. You understand what I'm saying? And I'm gonna tell you something. We've all made mistakes where we've let that toxic individual get, you know, we let them make us come up out of ourselves. I heard a comedian or somebody say, don't make me come out myself. You know what I'm saying? And it is so true. Like, don't make toxic people make you come out of character, make you come out yourself. You understand what I'm saying? But in the event that that happens and you come from, you forget who you are, you forget where you are, and you come down here, let me tell you how to deal with that. This is how a leader would deal with that, because we all make mistakes. You understand what I'm saying? We all make mistakes. So how you deal with that as a leader, how you deal with that like a boss, okay, is through humility. You understand what I'm saying? And you go to them and you make restitution with them and you apologize. It's not to say that what they did is right. Let me tell you something. Humility does not make you a loser. It don't make you weak. It is actually the exact opposite. It shows your strength. It shows your wisdom. It shows your integrity, and it shows your self-respect. Do you understand what I'm saying? It has nothing to do with, well, I'm just coming to say that you're right. Listen. By going and acknowledging you're wrong, you understand what I'm saying? By getting into that conflict with them, you're taking responsibility for your wrong. Do you understand what I'm saying? And I love how my pastor, when I was back in college, I had a pastor that said, give up your right to be right. And I believe it was in a book he gave me called How to Appeal to Authority, which I love. Authority don't necessarily how appealing to authority don't necessarily have to be an authority person. You understand what I'm saying? You can appeal to anyone. You can appeal to toxic people by just going to them, humbling yourself, and giving up your right to be right, and just taking responsibility for your actions. You understand what I'm saying? That is the right thing to do. That is the mature thing to do. That is the leadership thing to do. That is the right attitude to take. I guarantee your spirit man will love you for it. You understand what I'm saying? You talking about going to another level. You will feel good. You understand what I'm saying? So understand that humility, you know, and honesty, operating in a level of humility and honesty, man. And I got such a story time for this one, and I can't wait. I'll probably film it after I get done with this, because, man, I have a good story to tell behind this one, because it works. You understand what I'm saying? But the thing about it is, you have to really be humble. You can't operate in false humility. You understand what I'm saying? You really have to know where you erred and see your sin through the eyes of God. You understand what I'm saying? So yeah. So let's move on, guys. Okay, let's move on. Okay. Number five, and this is my last one, is respond calmly. Okay. When you're dealing with a toxic person who does nothing but argue, does nothing but point out negativity, they're very critical. You know, they're jealous. They're full of anger, hate, malice, resentment. Petty behaviors. You understand what I'm saying? Respond calmly. You know, respond calmly. You know, the worst thing that you can do, guys, is to come out of character and get angry with them, get into conflict with them, respond hate for hate, respond sarcasm for sarcasm, you know, respond critical, you know, behaviors with critical behaviors. You understand what I'm saying? No, respond calmly and respond in love. You understand what I'm saying? Let them say what they're gonna say. You know, and if you can excuse yourself, you know, and go to another room. You understand what I'm saying? But please respond calmly with dignity and self-respect. Let them be the fool. Let them be the one to go off. You understand what I'm saying? Let them be the one to come out of character. But don't let them pull you down to their level. Don't do that, guys. Don't do that. When they're going off, when they're saying ignorant things, in your mind, you should be saying, know who you are. Remember who you are. Remember where you're going. That's what you should be telling yourself. I am the king's kid. You know what I'm saying? My father's the great I am. I'm going places. You know, I got levels to achieve. I got goals to achieve. I'm too good for this. You know, I got too much class. You understand what I'm saying? So when this demon is going off in your face, you understand what I'm saying? And bringing all this toxic behavior and trying to spew it onto you and this and the other, just be calm. You know, and because if you can't leave and say it's on a job or whatever the case may be, you know, walk away with, you know, some type of, you know, handle it diplomatically, you know, respectfully remove yourself, you know, excuse yourself. You understand what I'm saying? But don't get into it with these people, because like the Bible says, you're going to lose every time, and they're going to trample over your words of wisdom. Okay. All right. So let me start to close this out. Okay. Let me just say this, guys. You guys have to keep in mind that you become the company that you keep. You understand what I'm saying? You are the company that you keep. I don't care how good you are. If there's more toxic people around you, and you're the only person that's trying to go somewhere in life, you're the only one that's trying to operate in some type of love and integrity, and you know, and you trying to level up in your spirit, man, and you trying to level up, you know, in your goals and in your vision, and you around, and there's more toxic people around you, eventually these toxic people is going to bring you down. Do you understand what I'm saying? This is why they say birds of a feather flock together. Watch the company that you keep. And people, well, I can handle being around this, and I can handle being around this, that, and the other. No, you cannot. Eventually, they're going to corrupt. The Bible says that what is it? The Bible says that bad company corrupts good morals. Do you understand what I'm saying? I'm going to try to put that scripture here in case I got it wrong. But I believe it says bad company corrupts good morals. Do you understand what I'm saying? Been there, guys. I've been there. I've done it. Everything I'm talking to you guys about, I've been there. I've been there and done it. It don't work. Surround yourselves with people who think like you, who's trying to go somewhere. You understand what I'm saying? Who carries the same spirit as you do. Trust me. Because if you're surrounded by fools, if you got four fools in your life, and you're the only one that's trying to operate in some type of integrity and righteousness, you're eventually going to be fool number five. I'm just saying. You know, you lay down with dogs, you wake up with fleas. That's true. Okay? Also, I heard someone say this. They said, what someone does to you is their karma. But how you respond is yours. Do you understand what I'm saying? That becomes your karma. So just because they're mistreating you and this, that, and the other, how you respond, your attitude towards it, that's going to become your karma. So make sure that you respond towards ignorance, towards foolish behavior, you know, towards these toxic people that's in your life. Let me tell you something. Keep it full of integrity. Keep it full of self-control. And keep it full of wisdom. Do you understand what I'm saying? And then last but not least, keep it full of love. That is the best advice, guys, that I can give you. That is how you disarm the toxic people in your life. That's how you go to levels. That's how you boss up. That's how you become a leader. Do you understand what I'm saying? If you can deal with toxic people, there's nothing in life that you can't conquer, that you can't achieve. Because I feel what makes a great leader, what makes a business successful is leadership. And what makes a great leader is how they are able to deal with people effectively. Do you understand what I'm saying? So I just want to like close out by saying that, number one, guys, you have to realize that toxic people, you're not going to be able to make them happy. They're never going to be happy. Toxic people, 9 times out of 10, they never take responsibility for their wrong behaviors. Okay? This is, again, shake the dust from your feet and keep it moving. Stop casting your pearls among swine. Remove yourself from them if you can. Do you understand what I'm saying? But just follow my advice, guys. And I guarantee you are not going to regret it. Okay? I guarantee you. So that's going to conclude this video, guys. If you found this advice helpful, you know, thumbs up this video. If you guys have not subscribed already, please subscribe. And don't forget, guys, turn on your notifications. Hit that notification button next to the subscribe button, the little bell, so that you guys are notified every time I put a new upload up. I'm trying to get these videos up like 2 or 3 times a week. So you're definitely not going to want to miss out, guys. And as always, I look forward to seeing you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.